This video was made in collaboration with Narutopedia. For more information, check out the link in the description. The Life of Sasuke Uchiha from Naruto. Sasuke Uchiha is one of the last surviving members of Konohagakure's Uchiha clan. After his older brother Itachi slaughtered their clan, Sasuke made it his mission in life to avenge them by killing Itachi. He is added to Team 7 upon becoming a ninja, and through competition with his rival and best friend Naruto Uzumaki, Sasuke starts developing his skills. Dissatisfied with his progress, he defects from Konoha so that he can acquire the strength needed to exact his revenge. His years of seeking vengeance and his actions that followed become increasingly demanding, irrational, and isolates him from others, leading him to be branded as an international criminal. After learning the truth of his brother's sacrifice, later proving instrumental in ending the Fourth Shinobi World War, and being happily redeemed by Naruto, Sasuke decides to return to Konoha and dedicate his life to help protect the village and its inhabitants, becoming referred to as the supporting Kage. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Sasuke Uchiha. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Early life. Sasuke is the second and youngest son of Mikoto and Fugaku Uchiha. They named him after Sasuke Sarutobi in the hopes that he would someday be just as strong as Shinobi. Sasuke grew up in the shadow of his older brother Itachi, a natural prodigy who many in the Uchiha clan and the village would constantly compare Sasuke and any of his accomplishments to. Sasuke himself adored Itachi, never passing up an opportunity to spend time with him. Although Itachi welcomed his company, letting Sasuke watch him train and taking him on adventures into the forests, Itachi in return rarely helped Sasuke himself become a better shinobi. When asked, he would often instead poke Sasuke's forehead and promise to do it some other time. Sasuke found this annoying, but didn't allow it to blemish his high opinion of his brother. On entering the Konoha Ninja Academy, Sasuke proved to be the standout of his class, consistently getting top grades. However, he could never meet the same milestones Itachi had set, resulting in their father paying Sasuke little attention. Aware of this neglect, Itachi, despite being increasingly busy, tried to stand in for their father by giving Sasuke the recognition he craved, at times even blackmailing Fugaku to spend time with Sasuke. As time went on, Itachi started becoming distant and cold towards their family, culminating in a falling out with much of the Uchiha clan on their suspicion that he'd killed his best friend, Shisui Uchiha. Sasuke did not understand the reason for this, but he didn't mind the side effect. His father began taking an interest in his and listening to his instructions allows them all to pass. After a series of uneventful D-rank missions, Naruto is able to secure a C-rank mission for Team 7, escorting Tazuna to the Land of Waves. Soon after leaving Konoha, they are attacked by the Demon Brothers. Naruto is paralyzed with fear, forcing Sasuke to step in to disarm them and protect Tazuna until Kakashi can capture them. Tazuna confesses that assassins have been hired to kill him, but that he couldn't afford the bodyguard detail he needs. Although the mission is now A-rank in nature, far beyond the skill of Genin, Team 7 decides to continue with it. For his earlier indecision, Sasuke declares Naruto a scaredy-cat, also known as a bibiri-kun. When they arrive in the Land of Waves, however, they are confronted by Zabuza Momochi. Sasuke experiences a crisis of his own, overwhelmed by the battle between Kakashi and Zabuza. He quickly regains his composure, and when Kakashi is caught in a water prison, he teams up with Naruto to break him out. In the end, Zabuza is seemingly killed by Haku, allowing Team 7 to escort Tazuna back to his house. Kakashi finds Zabuza's death suspicious and decides to train the team in case he returns. He has them perform the tree climbing practice to improve their chakra control, which will help them against Zabuza. Although Sasuke's control is initially much better than Naruto's, Naruto improves rapidly using advice from Sakura, who herself mastered it from the start. Sasuke asks Naruto to share Sakura's advice with him, and from competition between them, they each climb to the top of their trees. Naruto is exhausted from the training, so Team 7 leaves him behind the next morning as they resume their escort duties. They're met by Zabuza and Haku, the latter of whom Sasuke faces in battle. Because of Sasuke's speed and refined chakra control, Haku imprisons him with his demonic mirroring ice crystals. Naruto joins to help, but unaware of how Haku's mirrors work, joins Sasuke within the prison. Sasuke is unable to melt the mirrors with his fire, and Naruto is unable to break free with his shadow clones, leaving them at the mercy of Haku's senbon. As time passes, however, Sasuke becomes increasingly able to dodge Haku's attacks, a benefit of his awakening Sharingan. Seeing this, Haku decides to finish off Naruto so he can focus on Sasuke. Sasuke shields Naruto from Haku's attack with his own body when Naruto asks him why Sasuke claims his body acted on its own. Sasuke seemingly dies from his injuries. In truth, Haku only struck Sasuke's vital points to put him in a temporary death-like state, so he wakes up a short time later. By the time he does, both Haku and Zabuza are dead, so their bodyguard services are no longer required. When their injuries heal, they return home via the newly constructed Great Naruto Bridge. Chunin exams. Team 7 resumes its series of unremarkable missions. For their performance in the Land of Waves, however, Kakashi decides to enter them in the Chunin exams taking place in Konoha. Because they've only recently graduated from the academy, the three feel they must give strong showings to prove themselves. When they arrive at the exam hall, Sasuke first uses his Sharingan to dispel a genjutsu intended to discourage unqualified genin, and then agrees to spar with Rock Lee. Lee's speed and taijutsu skills impress Sasuke enough to use his Sharingan in their fight. Although he's able to see Lee's movements better, Sasuke can't physically keep up, and Lee nearly performs the front lotus on him. Lee is stopped by his teacher, Might Guy, whose emotional method of punishing Lee disturbs Sasuke, Naruto, and Sakura. During the exam's first stage, the participating genin are given a written test. Sasuke is unable to answer any of the questions, causing him to realize that the purpose of the first stage is to cheat without getting caught. He therefore uses his Sharingan to mimic the pencil movements of other examinees. Team 7 continues to the second stage in the Forest of Death, where to pass they must obtain a pair of scrolls, one of which they're given at the start, the other of which they must take from another team. Soon after entering, Sasuke discovers that what appears to be Naruto is an Ame-nin, Oboro in disguise. He drives Oboro off and locates the real Naruto. To prevent this from happening again, Sasuke comes up with a complicated password that they'll share to confirm their identities in case they get separated. They're immediately attacked, and when they regroup, Naruto correctly recites the answer. Knowing Naruto could have never remembered the password, Sasuke attacks the imposter. The imposter, Orochimaru, is far too strong for them to contend with and may very well kill them. Sasuke tries to forfeit their scroll in exchange for their lives, but Naruto, upon locating them, stops him, believing Sasuke may also be an enemy ninja in disguise because the Sasuke he knows would never surrender. Naruto engages Orochimaru in combat, defeats his snake, and calls Sasuke a scaredy cat before Orochimaru finally renders him unconscious. Amazed by Naruto's performance and encouraged by Sakura, Sasuke picks up where he left off by pinning Orochimaru down and attacking him with the Dragon Fire technique. Orochimaru is impressed by Sasuke and brands him with a cursed seal of heaven to reward him before leaving. The pain of the cursed seal overwhelms Sasuke and he passes out. When Sasuke regains consciousness, he finds Sakura badly injured, Rock Lee defeated in battle, and Team 10 defending them from Team Dosu, an Oto team. Sasuke questions Sakura on the identity of who hurt her, which Zaku Abumi takes credit for. Under the cursed seal's influence, Sasuke attacks Zaku and breaks both of his arms. He prepares to do the same to Zaku's teammates, but Sakura's pleas for him to stop bring him back to his senses, and the cursed seal recedes. The genin teams go their separate ways, and Team 7 spends several days recuperating from their ordeals. On the last day of the second stage, they go looking for the second scroll that they still need. They're found by Team Oboro, which Naruto distracts while the rest of Team 7 sneaks behind and knocks out. With two scrolls, Team 7 is able to advance to the preliminary round. Sasuke is paired against Yoroi Akado for the first match. Before the fight starts, Kakashi warns Sasuke that use of the cursed seal will disqualify him. Because he can't use chakra without the cursed seal activating, Sasuke is forced to only use taijutsu, something that proves difficult when Yoroi absorbs his chakra whenever he gets close. Sasuke ends up mimicking the portion of Rock Lee's front lotus he saw a few days earlier, inventing the lion combo to defeat him. Afterwards, Kakashi takes Sasuke aside and uses the evil sealing method on his cursed seal so that it won't flare up as often. Sasuke loses consciousness from the application, and by the time he wakes up, the preliminaries are already over. For the final matches taking place in a month, Sasuke was to face Gaara of Tsunagakure in the first round. In order to prepare him for this fight, and to give him an alternative to the cursed seal's power, Kakashi teaches him how to use Chidori, and helps him further emulate Lee's speed and fighting style. Their training runs long, and Sasuke in fact arrives late for his match, but he finds that they waited for him because the audience has anticipated the fight so much. Sasuke uses his speed to attack Gaara from multiple angles in a short time, leaving his shield of sand unable to block anything. Gaara surrounds himself with his sand so that Sasuke won't bother him while he prepares for the fight. Unable to get through the shield with physical attacks, Sasuke pierces it with Chidori. Gaara's arm is wounded and his shield dissolves, but not before Sasuke briefly senses Shukaku within him. Before the fight can continue, however, a genjutsu descends on the stadium. Konoha Crush. The invasion of Konoha begins, forcing the cancellation of the Chunin exams. As Konoha Nin in the stadium start engaging the invading Suna and Oto forces, the exam proctor Genma Shiranui sends Sasuke after the escaping Gaara. Konkuro attempts to delay Sasuke, but Shino Aburame appears to fight Konkuro in Sasuke's place. By the time Sasuke catches up with him, Gaara is already in the process of transforming into Shukaku. Gaara attacks with increased speed and strength, which Sasuke is only narrowly able to avoid. He counters with Chidori and succeeds in injuring Gaara yet again, but Gaara is still able to continue fighting. Sasuke, who has already reached his limit of using Chidori twice a day, is low on options. He's able to use a third Chidori by using his cursed seal, but is left paralyzed afterwards and at Gaara's mercy. Sasuke is saved by the timely arrival of Naruto and Sakura, sent by Kakashi to provide assistance. Sakura is quickly captured, and Naruto initially struggles against Gaara. Sasuke volunteers to use what little strength he has to distract Gaara while Naruto escapes with Sakura, but Naruto is unwilling to do so. Instead, Naruto taps into a mysterious chakra source, creates 1,000 shadow clones, and soon after summons Gamabunta, each of which amazes Sasuke. Naruto ultimately defeats Gaara, but he's not able to move. Sasuke collects him and takes him back to Konoha with Sakura. A few days later, Team 7 attends the third Hokage's funeral. Search for Tsunade. Sasuke arrives at a dango shop to meet Kakashi for lunch. Not only does he find that Kakashi has arrived uncharacteristically early, but Kakashi abruptly cancels soon afterwards. When Sasuke stops by Kakashi's home later that day, he finds Kakashi is comatose. The assembled Jonin avoid divulging what happened to him until Alba Yamashiro unwittingly reveals that Itachi has returned to Konoha in search of Naruto. Sasuke immediately starts tracking Naruto down so that he can, in turn, fight Itachi. He stops by Ramen Ichiraku and is informed that Naruto has gone to Shukuba Town with Jiraiya. Sasuke locates the inn where Naruto is staying shortly after Itachi does the same. Itachi allows Sasuke an opportunity to demonstrate how much stronger he's become, which he does by attacking with Chidori. Itachi easily blocks the attack and breaks Sasuke's arm, but he is stopped from going any further by the arrival of Jiraiya. When Jiraiya states his intention to defeat both Itachi and his partner Kisame Hoshigaki, Sasuke demands that Itachi be left for him. Uninterested, Itachi kicks Sasuke away and uses Tsukiyomi to force him to experience their parents' murders over and over again. Before Sasuke passes out, Itachi informs him that he is still weak. Sasuke is hospitalized, comatose like Kakashi before him. It isn't until Naruto brings Tsunade to Konoha that the trauma to their minds is healed. Land of Tea Escort Mission. In the anime, Team 7 is sent to the Land of Tea to protect Idate Morino. During the mission, they are brought into conflict with Aoi Rokusho. Although Sasuke is able to help break Aoi's sword of the Thunder God with his Chidori, he is injured during the fight and must be hospitalized when they get back to Konoha. Sasuke Recovery Mission. While recuperating, Sasuke reflects on his encounter with Itachi, along with Aoi's mocking in the anime, and is upset that after all this time, Itachi is still so much stronger than he is. He is also jealous of Naruto, who, despite being the worst student in their academy class, has seemingly surpassed Sasuke, evidenced by his defeat of Gaara. Determined to prove himself superior, Sasuke challenges Naruto to a fight when he comes to visit him in the hospital. At first, Naruto refuses because Sasuke is still in no condition to fight, but Sasuke persists and Naruto agrees. The fight escalates quickly, culminating with Sasuke using Chidori and Naruto using Rasengan. Kakashi arrives and deflects their attacks into opposing water towers before they can clash. Sasuke initially believes his Chidori was at least stronger based on the damage to their respective water towers, but upon closer examination finds that Naruto's water tower is destroyed. Sasuke leaves, jealous of Naruto's development. Kakashi tracks Sasuke down afterwards and lectures him. The Chidori is supposed to be used to protect friends, not attack them. Kakashi reminds Sasuke that no matter how painful the losses of the past are, it would be worse to lose the friends he still has. Kakashi leaves him to think over what he said, and Sasuke becomes conflicted between his desire for revenge and his friendship with Naruto and Sakura. Before he can take Kakashi's words to heart, Sasuke is confronted by the Sound Four. Sent by Orochimaru, the Sound Four fight with Sasuke to test his abilities and quickly defeat him. He tries using his cursed seal to gain the upper hand, but discovers that they each have cursed seals too. The Sound Four offer to take him to Orochimaru so that he can gain strength like theirs, which he'll never achieve if he remains in Konoha. Desperate to become stronger than Itachi, Sasuke decides to take the Sound Four up on the offer and leaves during the night. As he approaches the village's exit, he is met by Sakura, who tries to persuade him to stay so as to not break up Team 7. When this doesn't work, Sakura confesses her love for him and asks to be allowed to accompany him at the very least. Sasuke refuses again, so she threatens to call for help. He stops her by knocking her out, but thanks her before he does. He meets the Sound Four outside the village, and they start guiding him to Orochimaru. Once they're far enough away from Konoha, the Sound Four gives Sasuke some medication that will mature his curse seal to a second, stronger state. He's left unconscious while his body adjusts to the drug, but when he finally wakes up many hours later, his body is much stronger. Ecstatic, Sasuke continues on to Orochimaru by himself, paying little attention to the Sound 4's ongoing battle with the Sasuke recovery team. Sasuke is stopped at the Valley of the End by Naruto. Sasuke ignores his pleas to return to Konoha and is unmoved by Naruto's warnings that Orochimaru will take his body, believing that such a sacrifice is worthwhile if it will lead to Itachi's death. Naruto starts attacking him, ready to take him back to Konoha by force if necessary. Sasuke returns the attacks as a way of resuming the fight that Kakashi interrupted earlier. He also decides to kill Naruto, remembering Itachi's explanation that killing one's closest friend will awaken the Mangekyo Sharingan. With his cursed seal, Sasuke is able to land a number of serious blows. Although Naruto didn't want to believe that Sasuke would really kill him, his mounting injuries convince him otherwise and force him to call on the powers of the Nine Tails within him. Sasuke is surprised by the insidious chakra he senses, the sudden healing of Naruto's wounds, and the increases to his strength and speed. Sasuke becomes angry and asks Naruto why he would go so far for him, to which Naruto responds that Sasuke is like a brother to him, and he simply can't let him go. Sasuke acknowledges their bond and promises to sever it, but does at least put on the forehead protector that until now he refused to do Naruto the courtesy of wearing. He boasts that Naruto will not even be able to scratch the forehead protector. They continue trading blows, with Naruto eventually manifesting a fox-shaped cloak, and Sasuke entering his curse seal's second level. Sasuke clashes his Chidori with Naruto's Rasengan, and within the Dome of Resulting Energy, they finally trade blows. Sasuke punches Naruto, and Naruto scratches Sasuke's forehead protector, proving his earlier boast wrong in the process. When the energy dissipates, Sasuke stands over an unconscious Naruto, wounded and with no energy left to finish him. He decides not to kill him since that's what Itachi would want him to do, and he refuses to let Itachi decide his actions. He leaves his forehead protector behind with Naruto and continues on to Orochimaru by himself. When he finally reaches Orochimaru's lair, he discovers that Orochimaru has already found a new body. Sasuke is unconcerned, only wanting whatever power Orochimaru can give him. In Naruto's footsteps, the friends' paths. In the anime, approximately 2 years into his training with Orochimaru, Sasuke volunteers to deliver some research material to one of Orochimaru's hideouts. While there, Sasuke releases one of Orochimaru's test subjects, Suigetsu Hozuki, from his confinements, and then helps Karin capture Suigetsu yet again. Pleased with what he witnesses of their abilities, Sasuke resolves to win them both over so he can have them as allies in the future. Tenchi Bridge Reconnaissance Mission. 2.5 years after leaving Konoha, Sasuke waits impatiently at one of Orochimaru's hideouts in Kusagakure. When Orochimaru finally returns, Sasuke demands that he resume their training. Before complying, Orochimaru introduces him to Sai, his replacement in Team 7, but Sasuke isn't interested. Sai tries to engage Sasuke by discussing Naruto, prompting Sasuke to knock him over with killing intent. Sai persists, telling Sasuke that Naruto thinks of him as a brother. Sasuke replies that he only has one brother, whom he will kill. Sai tracks him down later as he rests. Sasuke demands an explanation for the disturbance, and Sai reveals that he wishes to reunite Sasuke with Naruto so as to re-establish the brotherly bond they had. Annoyed, Sasuke attacks him. Naruto, Sakura, and Yamato, Kakashi's replacement, are attacked at the site of Sasuke's attack. Sai is unharmed and is prepared to help them bring him back to Konoha. Sasuke reacts with indifference to Sakura and Naruto, chastising the latter for still pursuing him after all these years. Sasuke also goes on to tell Naruto that he couldn't simply break their bond by killing him, and that he only spared Naruto's life from their first fight on a whim, but intends to kill him for real this time. To demonstrate that they mean nothing to him, Sasuke quickly neutralizes them all, his growth under Orochimaru being far greater than any of them expected. Naruto, frustrated by this, struggles to avoid the temptation of using Ninetales. Seeing this, Sasuke enters Naruto's subconscious using his Sharingan and suppresses the Ninetales, but not before the beast noted Sasuke's similarity to Madara Uchiha in terms of visual prowess and chakra. He escapes Yamato's attempt to capture him and prepares to kill them all, but is stopped by Orochimaru. Orochimaru points to their recent successes against Akatsuki, the organization that Itachi belongs to, and explains that letting them live may further weaken Akatsuki, thereby making it easier to kill Itachi. Sasuke accepts this reasoning, and they leave Team 7 behind. Three Tails Appearance. In the anime, Sasuke meets one of Orochimaru's test subjects, Yukimaru, who is picking white camellias. Naruto Shinden, Parent and Child Day. As Sasuke finished business with a village near Konohagakure, he decided to return home to visit his family. There he learned from Boruto of the new village holiday, Parent and Child Day. Told where Sarada was, Sasuke decided to spend the day with his daughter. While Sarada was overjoyed at the idea, the normally poised man struggled to connect with his daughter, simply trying to get inspiration wherever he could, instead simply embarrassing Sarada. Finally having enough, Sarada stormed off. Sasuke was then approached by Sakura. He discussed with her his problem in connecting with Sarada. Sakura noticed that, having spent much of Sarada's life away and only hearing stories about Sasuke and his various exploits, Sarada probably became disillusioned at who Sasuke was as a person, and his attempts at being a doting father seemed lame. Ultimately, Sakura suggested that he should approach Sarada more like Sasuke's relationship was with his father and brother back in the day, just enjoying the time they have together and talk about their goals. Later, while working on her shuriken skills, Sasuke approached her again, applauding her on her goal of becoming Hokage. He insisted that she would make a better Hokage than he ever could and would support her through her struggles, much to her delight. As the day ended, she and Sasuke returned home where the entire Uchiha family enjoyed a hearty meal together. Versus Momoshiki Arc. As Sasuke continued his investigation, he found the remains of a stronger crop of white Zetsu in the mountain's graveyard, which he proceeded to destroy with a Amaterasu. Upon arriving at Kaguya's ice dimension, Sasuke locates a scroll in Kaguya's palace. There, he's attacked by Kinshiki and Momoshiki Otsutsuki. While capable of fighting the former on equal terms, he realizes he can't take them both on at once. By using his Rinnegan's abilities, he is ultimately able to escape. Unable to read the scroll with his Rinnegan, Sasuke takes it back to Konoha to have it deciphered. He stops at Naruto's house to deliver it to him, but is attacked by Naruto's son, Boruto Uzumaki, who mistook Sasuke for his father. Sasuke easily blocks the attack and asks for Naruto's whereabouts. Hinata, Naruto's wife, tells him Naruto is still at the Hokage's office. On finding Naruto, Sasuke remarks that Boruto is quite similar to him. Naruto disagrees, thinking he has more in common with Sasuke, but retracts and says Boruto isn't like him either. Naruto thinks they are behind the new generation, which Sasuke disagrees with because the nature of shinobi never changes, and they make a bet over this. As Sasuke leaves to go home to his family, Boruto launches a sneak attack. Sasuke once again avoids it effortlessly and pushes Boruto over. Impressed, Boruto asks Sasuke to train him, having heard that Sasuke is Naruto's only equal and thus best qualified to help him become stronger than his father. Sasuke tells Boruto to ask him again after he's learned to use the Rasengan. Boruto does just that and demonstrates it after he becomes able to form it. On seeing it, Sasuke remarks that Boruto's Rasengan is quite small, which Boruto wrongly believes is to mean he's been rejected, causing him to subsequently run off. Sarada then reveals herself to her father and tries to convince him that he's being too hard on Boruto, and he usually didn't apply that kind of dedication to anything. Sasuke tells his daughter that Boruto jumped to the wrong conclusion and that he was going to agree to make him his student. In truth, Sasuke was quite satisfied, further impressed by the lightning nature Boruto applies to his Rasengan. The next day, Boruto demonstrates a normal-sized Rasengan, which Sasuke recognizes to be a result of using the Kote. Boruto tries to cover this up by boasting about his exceptional skill being the reason for the remarkable progress of his Rasengan. Sasuke cryptically references the fact that Boruto was willing to cheat to attain his goals by saying Boruto was quite different from Naruto and hoped it wasn't the case. Nonetheless, he agrees to train Boruto since he had already met his requirement. He later spoke to Boruto's Jonin sensei, Konohamaru Sarutobi, who agreed to let Sasuke take over his actual training. After his day training with Sasuke, the two sit by a fire and talk. Boruto starts asking about his father's weaknesses. Sasuke explains that Naruto has many weaknesses, but nonetheless managed to pull himself up and become Hokage. Believing Boruto's approach to be incorrect, Sasuke explained that Naruto is better understood by the hardships he overcame in his life than the flaws that he may have. This doesn't satisfy Boruto, so he throws himself into training for the upcoming Chunin exams, shuriken jutsu figuring prominently in Sasuke's lessons. While training, Boruto struggles with bending his throws, complaining that shuriken jutsu is Sarada's specialty because she is Sasuke's daughter. Sasuke retorts this assertion by applying the same reasoning to Boruto regarding the shadow clone technique, of which Boruto can only create two as opposed to his father who can create thousands. Sasuke keeps tabs on how deciphering the scroll is going, but it isn't until the day of the Chunin exam's finals that it is finally finished. Reading what it says, Sasuke finds his suspicions about the threat Kaguya was preparing for confirmed and rushes to inform Naruto. When he arrives at the stadium where the finals are being held, Kinshiki and Momoshiki are already attacking. Sasuke rescues Sarada from falling debris, but is confronted by Kinshiki when he tries to get her to safety. Shikamaru Nara briefly restrains Kinshiki and Momoshiki, allowing Sasuke to tell Naruto that the scroll says that Kinshiki and Momoshiki harvest planet's chakra in order to prolong their lives, and that Kaguya was building a white Zetsu army to prepare for their inevitable invasion. As Momoshiki starts attacking, Naruto forms his tailed beast mode around Boruto and Sarada in order to protect them. Sasuke layers his Susanoo over this to provide additional protection. The shield is insufficient against Momoshiki, so Naruto instructs Sasuke to focus on protecting the children while he fights Momoshiki alone. Sasuke does so, staying with Boruto and Sarada, and as a result, preventing them from stopping Naruto's capture. With his father gone, Boruto feels guilty about how he treated Naruto and reprimanded himself for being so uncool. Overhearing this, Sasuke affirmed Boruto's words and noted that if it weren't for his mother and sister, he would be in the same position Naruto would be in the past. After Boruto asks Sasuke how his father overcame his hardships, Sasuke suggests Boruto ask Naruto in person and also telling him Naruto is stronger than him up until now, and to that end invites Boruto to join him in rescuing him. When Boruto asks why he'd been invited, and why Sasuke agreed to train him in the first place, Sasuke explains that Boruto is an exceptionally gifted shinobi and has the potential to surpass Naruto because he hates to lose. The five Kage then reveal themselves and offer their assistance to rescue Naruto, revealing that they are on friendly terms with Sasuke. Before they leave, however, Sasuke lends his forehead protector to Boruto, who had his confiscated by Naruto for cheating in the exams. Sasuke uses his Rinnegan to open a portal to Momoshiki's planet. Before they leave, Hinata tries to stop Boruto from leaving, who then puts on Sasuke's headband and affirms confidently that he's going to go save his father, reminding Hinata of Naruto when he was young. Sasuke approves of this demeanor and notes that Boruto is finally starting to carry himself like a true shinobi. When they arrive on Momoshiki's planet, which has long since had its chakra harvested, the group frees Naruto from Momoshiki and Kinshiki, who had him bound to a tree resembling the god tree, and immediately engage them in battle. Sasuke assists the 6th Mizukage and 4th Tsuchikage with restraining Kinshiki, and then joins Naruto, the 5th Kazekage, and the 5th Raikage against Momoshiki. He warns them not to use ninjutsu since Momoshiki can absorb them. Kinshiki breaks free and drives them back, then allows Momoshiki to absorb him to become stronger. Naruto and Sasuke start fighting Momoshiki with taijutsu, during the course of which Sasuke is badly burned. Naruto catches him and heals his wounds with the Nine Tails Chakra, allowing them to continue their tailed beast mode and Susanoo to strike him down. With Momoshiki down, the uninvited Katasuke tries to finish him off. This unwittingly revives Momoshiki, giving him a chance to paralyze Naruto and the Kage with Shadow Paralysis Jutsu while Sasuke elsewhere protects Boruto. Sasuke suggests that Boruto attack Momoshiki with his Rasengan, depending on its lightning nature to catch him off guard. This works and the Kage are freed, but an earlier injury prevents Naruto from fighting. He adds his chakra to Boruto's Rasengan, which Sasuke then helps him find an opening to use to destroy Momoshiki with. After the battle, Sasuke tells Naruto he won their bet when they returned to Konoha, and Sasuke posed for a photograph with Naruto, Boruto, and the other Kage. However, in the anime, before they departed from the other dimension, Sasuke managed to catch a glimpse of Boruto's conversation with Momoshiki's fading spirit thanks to his Rinnegan, as well as notice that some technique had been used to stop the flow of time, so the conversation passed unseen for everyone else. After everything returns to normal, apart from concern about the third Otsutsuki foe who escaped, Sasuke meets with Boruto again. He reveals that he knows about his mark from Momoshiki, insisting that Boruto let him know if anything had happened from it. He also let Boruto keep his old forehead protector as a sign of being Sasuke's official pupil. Sasuke decided to take advantage of his research being analyzed to spend a few days with his family. Later, Sasuke and Sakura, both smiling, watch Sarada and her teammates leave for a mission. Soon afterwards, Sasuke returned to his investigation of the Otsutsuki. In the anime, Sasuke came back to the village to give Naruto information and told him not to promote Sarada to Chunin due to refusal to obey direct orders. One Tail Escort Arc. In the anime, having notified Tsunagakure that the Otsutsuki were searching for Shukaku, Sasuke, alongside Gaara, Kankuro, and a Suna Genin team assembled at the Tailed Beast's location. Sasuke sent a messenger hawk to inform Konoha of the location and that he might be on Urashiki Otsutsuki's tail. There, Sasuke and Gaara fought Urashiki and his puppets. As the two sides battled evenly, Boruto suddenly appeared, prompting Sasuke to protect his student, leading him to become distracted and Urashiki taking some of his chakra. As Sasuke leapt towards his opponent, Urashiki teleported him to another dimension. He ultimately arrived in Kaguya's ice dimension. While unharmed, his battle exhausted him too much. Sasuke was forced to spend time to recover his chakra to return to Tsunagakure, as his Rinnegan was too weak to maintain a portal. Once recovering enough chakra, he detected Urashiki's repeated dimension hopping and teleported in time to stop the foe from striking down Boruto and Shinki. Sasuke's return prompted Urashiki to retreat. Sasuke brought the Genin to Konohagakure for treatment and reported the events to Naruto. There, it was decided that Shukaku would remain in Naruto's protection until better precautions were made. Time Slip Arc. In the anime, as Sasuke began enjoying some downtime in the village, he was approached by Boruto. The pupil asks Sasuke about the nature of Jiraiya's worth as a ninja and his relationship with Naruto. Sasuke admitted that Jiraiya was a remarkable man, whose influence and guidance strongly shaped Naruto into the remarkable man he is today, even noting that they ultimately shared a father-son relationship. When Boruto asked if Sasuke could get him an Icha Icha book to learn more about the man, Sasuke bluntly refused, knowing that Boruto was too young for such an adult book. Later, Sasuke learned from Naruto and Shikamaru that Urashiki was on the move again, being even more indiscriminate in his stealing of chakra. Later, when Boruto was annoyed that he was the only genin that was put off of the mission to hunt Urashiki due to the Otsutsuki's previous vendetta against him, Sasuke, however, offered him an alternate plan of making Boruto a two-man team with him while staying within the village, which Naruto agreed to. Later that night, Urashiki was discovered and most of the Konoha nin in the village went after him. Sasuke, however, doubted that things were working so smoothly, especially after learning that Genjutsu specialist Mirai Sarutobi went missing knowing of Urashiki's ability to replicate people's techniques from their chakra. Boruto doubted Urashiki would go after his father as he was still well guarded. He then realized Urashiki's true motive was an artifact found by the Konohagakure archaeological research team. His hunch is proven true when he and Sasuke engage in combat with Urashiki. The artifact turned out to be a turtle belonging to the Otsutsuki named Karasuki that required enough chakra to operate. Urashiki activates it while Boruto and Sasuke followed him. They entered a void where they battled, knocking Urashiki off a ledge too soon for him. When Karasuki finished its operation, Boruto and Sasuke found themselves back in Konohagakure, but to their shock, they realized that they had been sent to the past. Realizing Urashiki's plan was to acquire Kurama's chakra from Naruto as a child, Sasuke asked Karasuki about the enemy. The turtle explained that due to Sasuke's interference, Urashiki would not arrive in this time period for a few days. It also warned Sasuke and Boruto to avoid as much interaction with the past as possible, or risk severe changes to the timeline as they know it. Taking this to heart, Sasuke and Boruto disguised themselves and stressed their situation to Boruto as he discovered how different the village was. Soon afterwards, Boruto and Sasuke bumped into Naruto and Jiraiya, who were in trouble for peeping on the women's hot spring. Jiraiya handed Boruto his binoculars, trying to frame him for his peeping, but the issue was quickly resolved as Tsunade arrived and scolded both Naruto and Jiraiya for their actions. Tsunade asked about Boruto and Sasuke's arrival, and Sasuke claimed they were traveling performers who utilized ninjutsu during their performances. Still somewhat suspicious, Tsunade ordered Naruto and Jiraiya to guard Boruto and Sasuke, proclaiming that a recently defected genin, as well as Konoha still recovering from an assault during the Chunin exams, they needed to remain on their guard at all times, and couldn't afford to let strangers walk into their village. However, as soon as Tsunade leaves, Jiraiya left Naruto to take care of Boruto and Sasuke, much to Naruto's annoyance. As they walk around the village, they come across Sakura, and while Naruto approaches her, Sasuke leaves the area, warning Boruto that since he and Sakura were close, she could recognize him and drastically alter the future, and informed Boruto to remain by Naruto's side at all times before leaving. Days later, Sasuke bumped into Sakura again, dropping an old smeared letter from Sarada in the process. Eventually, Boruto confronted Sasuke about his past, having deduced the truth about his past self's absence. Still ashamed of his past mistakes, Sasuke simply admitted that at the time he saw no other way to accomplish his goal of revenge. When Boruto suggested finding his younger self to reason with him, Sasuke bluntly said they can't make such a risk. The following day, Urashiki finally appeared, prompting Sasuke and Boruto to guard the future Hokage. Urashiki acted quickly and struck Naruto with his hook, shocked to see that it failed to gain any chakra. Deciding the best course was to capture Naruto, Urashiki subdued Naruto and trapped Boruto and Sasuke, along with Jiraiya, who happened along inside a stone prison. Sasuke explained to Jiraiya that he and Boruto were actually ninja from a distant village with a mission to stop Urashiki from stealing the Ninetales chakra, and that Urashiki had ties to Akatsuki. While seeing that they were still hiding some truth, Jiraiya decided to work with the duo, breaking them free by summoning a giant toad. Soon, Sasuke locked onto Naruto's location from detecting the tailed beast's chakra beginning to leak out. Along the way, having realized that the 8-trigram sealing style was stopping Urashiki from stealing the Ninetales chakra, Jiraiya placed powerful seals on Boruto and Sasuke to protect them as well. Upon finding Naruto, Urashiki's actions forced the boy into his version 1 state. While Sasuke engaged Urashiki, Jiraiya and Boruto went to subdue the rampaging Naruto. Boruto attempted to reason with his father, believing that talking would restore his sanity, but quickly became horrified as his efforts failed and Naruto ended up nearly killing him before Jiraiya subdued Naruto. After Urashiki retreats, Jiraiya tends to Boruto's wounds and talks about Naruto's lonely childhood and hatred suffered by the villagers, and suggests that Boruto train with him alongside Naruto, knowing the foe would return and believed that the two children's compatible nature, they would work and learn well together. The following day, Sasuke watched from afar as Jiraiya began instructing Naruto and Boruto on how to synchronize their chakra to create a new cooperation ninjutsu. As the day continued and the two children struggled to complete the task, Boruto, still reeling from being attacked by Naruto's berserker attack while influenced by Kurama's chakra, decided to distance himself from the increasingly angry Naruto. Jiraiya then approached Sasuke, asking him to deliver Naruto some food while he dealt with something. Sasuke reluctantly agreed. Upon confronting his best friend's past self, Sasuke was amazed to learn how, even back then, how committed Naruto was to save Sasuke from his dark path. Ashamed to see how much pain he put Naruto through, Sasuke told Naruto about how a friend struggled for years to help him after he lost his way, but never gave up until finally succeeding. After renewing Naruto's conviction, Sasuke left. He was then approached by Jiraiya again, shocking Sasuke by deducing who he really was. As Jiraiya dryly laughed off his accusation, he remained firm on his suspicion that he was connected to the rogue genin. Jiraiya could tell that Sasuke and Boruto's desire to protect Naruto was genuine, and that they had their reason for keeping secrets. He made a deal with Sasuke not to delve deeper into their true identities, provided that Sasuke reveal all he knows about Urashiki. Sasuke then explained all he knew about the alien's abilities. After hearing all this, Jiraiya deemed that the best course of action would be to seal away Urashiki. Before they could formulate a proper plan, Sasuke detected Urashiki's return, speeding off with Jiraiya to help Boruto and Naruto. With Sasuke still drained from Urashiki's theft of his chakra, Sasuke struggled to keep up with the foe, even with the Sanin's aid. As Urashiki repeatedly evaded his foe's attacks, he smugly told them that he can see the future. Finding Urashiki's newest technique too dangerous, Sasuke tackled Urashiki and himself into the river to give his allies a chance to escape. While Urashiki escaped from the river unharmed and furious at Sasuke's constant interference, an unconscious Sasuke was fished out of the river by Sakura, who hid him and began treating him with their medical ninjutsu. Soon, Sasuke awoke, accidentally thanking Sakura by her given name. While not fully recovered, Sasuke decided to go help his friends. Sakura began asking him questions, but her efforts at healing him exhausted her and she fainted. Sasuke gently lay her down before heading off. He arrived to see his allies facing a transformed Urashiki. Their combined efforts barely were able to compete with the foe. Ultimately, seeing his friends get hurt made Naruto unleash his version 1 cloak again and went on a rampage. Boruto, however, managed to reach Naruto and together they were able to perfect their new collaboration technique. With the combined effort of Jiraiya and Sasuke, the two kids were able to plow through Urashiki's final attack and obliterate him. Days later, after everyone recovered from battle, Sasuke and Boruto decided to leave soon as their mission was complete. They were approached by Sakura, who demanded for Sasuke to reveal how he knew her and what the contents of his letter were about. While Sasuke struggled to answer, Jiraiya gave a convincing alibi that Sasuke and Boruto were in fact such avid fans of his they studied up on his entire life and wished to train under him, which Boruto and Sasuke awkwardly agreed to. The following day, after Sasuke used his Sharingan to erase the memories of everyone in the past they had made contact with to protect the timeline, the master and student used Karasuki to return to their time. Also, knowing that it was too dangerous for anyone else to wield the turtle's power, Sasuke and Boruto convinced it to go on a journey of self-discovery to find its own path. Once arriving in their present, Sasuke informed Naruto about the recent adventure and of Urashiki's demise. While Naruto was glad that the peace had been restored to the world, Sasuke insisted that there were still hidden sites of Kaguya that he would have to investigate, but noted that he would make sure to visit his family much more regularly. Mujina Bandits Arc. Boruto later tells Sasuke of his encounter with Momoshiki and informs him of the mark on his palm, leading to Sasuke telling Boruto that it wasn't normal and also to be on guard. After Shojoji was apprehended, Sai and Sasuke come in to interrogate him. As he questions Shojoji about the mark on Boruto's palm, Shojoji reveals that it's associated with the organization known as Kara, and the mark's nature is vaguely similar to Orochimaru's Jūinjutsu. Kara Actuation Arc. In the anime, after Sasuke finished probing Shōichi's mind, he learned that Kara was allegedly last seen in Amagakure. Sasuke was aided by Team 25 to investigate this new shadow organization. There, he learned that the village had decayed greatly since the last Great War. After Sai's team mapped out a series of underground tunnels, Sasuke and Sai went in alone. As they entered the area, they were assaulted by Garashi Tono, an orphaned citizen of Amagakure. He insisted that they were enemies who killed his friends. He was quickly subdued, and they explained their situation. Calming down, Garashi explained how a group of people were conducting an experiment underground. Garashi agreed to take them through the tunnels. This, however, turned out to be a trap, as Garashi ensnared the Konoha Nin and gassed them, revealing himself to be a supporter of Kara after the struggles he had to endure since the Fourth Shinobi World War. Sasuke saw through this deception after recognizing the look of shameless anger about him, using shadow clones to bait him. Before they could get information from him, Garashi was also tricked by Kara, as his gas mask was tampered with and he succumbed to the poison gas. As the tunnels began to collapse from another trap, they learned that Kara had been stationed there and was performing biological experiments. Sai and Sasuke reported their findings to Konohagakure. Afterwards, with the growing threat of Kara, Sasuke feared for his disciple's safety and loaned Boruto his other glove, instructing him to keep his Kama hidden at all costs. Sasuke learned that Victor, president of the Land of Valley's premier medical and research company, was in fact a member of Kara, and somehow acquired a sample of the first Hokage's cells. After Team 7 was defeated by two inners of Kara, Boruto and Sarada both approached Sasuke for help in growing stronger. He agreed to train Sarada, but upon learning of Boruto's desire to improve his Rasengan, Sasuke directed him to Kakashi, as Boruto didn't want to detract from his father's work, and Kakashi was the only other Rasengan user in the village. As Sarada began her training under Sasuke, she asked him to teach her his Chidori for superior penetrating power. Sasuke noted Chidori is a dangerous technique that draws its strength from a fierce linear path, and as such, only a superior perception can offset the normally reduced field of vision, something that Sarada's lesser Sharingan couldn't handle, as its natural range of vision was still too limited. Deciding to help Sarada master and improve her Sharingan, Sasuke focused her training on dodging a barrage of ball bearings similar to her previous enemy's technique. He would drill her on not overly relying on the Sharingan's natural insight, but rather focus on the entire area and let the Sharingan fill in the blanks. As Sarada began improving in her movements against barrage attacks, Sasuke noted that she was still very limited on how long she could maintain her Sharingan. When he suggested improving her stamina, Sarada asked about the Mangekyo Sharingan. Concerned about such a dangerous power, Sasuke insisted it was for another day. Soon, they were approached by Sakura. She was concerned Sarada was pushing herself too hard after just recovering, and even more horrified to hear her talk about the Mangekyo Sharingan. While Sakura insisted that she couldn't push herself so recklessly, Sarada was furious to hear her mother coddle her so, refusing to see why she wanted to get stronger, and stormed off. Along with his wife, Sasuke admitted to worrying about the path Sarada was potentially walking, but insisted she is as strong as they were back then. The following day, as Sarada continued struggling to evade all of Sasuke's barrages, Sakura approached again. She insisted that just blindly facing the challenge wouldn't yield any results. She forced Sarada into a sparring match with her, which Sasuke agreed to as Sakura's insight could determine things he couldn't. After Sakura quickly overwhelmed Sarada, she noticed that Sarada's biggest problems were her still underdeveloped chakra control and fear of defeat, which were inhibiting her development. Determined to break past her limits, Sarada faced down Sakura again, using her Sharingan to mimic the movements and general timing of Sakura's attacks to mimic Sakura's chakra-enhanced strength and reach a standstill. Sasuke was impressed by his daughter, and Sakura was now determined to help Sarada overcome her limits by joining in her training. Owl Arc. During Naruto's fight against Boruto at the training hall, Sasuke watches the match from the sidelines. Afterwards, Sasuke arrives at the Hokage's office, where he tells Boruto of the value of scientific ninja weapons and that the danger of the world has yet to be driven out. He explains of a coming danger of enemies like the Otsutsuki clan. Naruto also admitted to knowing about Boruto's mark on his right palm, which was another reason Naruto approved the development of this advanced weaponry. While Boruto still insisted that they would rely solely on ninjutsu like in the Chunin exams, Naruto noted that the Chunin exams were to test one's growth as a ninja, whereas they are now in a battle for survival. Katasuke then arrived to retrieve his prototype, to which Naruto assigned Team Konohamaru a C-rank mission to escort the lead scientist back to the lab in Ryuben City. While Boruto stormed off in a huff, Sasuke is certain Boruto will calm down soon enough. Kawaki Arc. Sasuke was sent to investigate coordinates discovered in intel recovered by Konohamaru, a location accessible only through space-time ninjutsu. He discovered an Otsutsuki-related site which contained records on some of their members, specifically those who had been to their world, which also led him to believe Kaguya came to this world with a partner. There, he also discovered another Ten Tails imprisoned. Sasuke managed to hide when Jigen arrived, but was left terrified when the leader of Kara absorbed some of the Ten Tails chakra for himself, briefly taking the form of Kaguya's supposed partner. As Jigen left to retrieve Kawaki, Sasuke determined the situation to be direr than he expected and felt the need to inform Naruto at once. Jigen later attacked Konohagakure and sent Naruto to an unknown dimension. Just as he was about to leave Naruto stranded, Sasuke, having detected Naruto's chakra and followed him there, appeared and kicked Jigen away to stop him from leaving before proceeding to team up with Naruto to fight Jigen, free to fight at full power, but even then Jigen successfully pressured them with his ability to seemingly conjure black rods from nowhere to stab them. However, Sasuke eventually deduced that Jigen's ability allowed him to shrink matter to microscopic levels and return it to its original size instantaneously, but told Naruto that wasn't his only secret uneasily. Recognizing Sasuke's impressive analytical skills and prowess with his dojutsu, Jigen noted that he must eliminate Sasuke first. Naruto and Sasuke continued to engage Jigen, eventually pushing him into a corner, at which point Jigen responded by progressing his karma to the next stage, worrying Sasuke, who saw it firsthand. Sasuke informed Naruto that Jigen's appearance was similar to an unknown Otsutsuki he had witnessed earlier, as well as that he was aware of the existence of another Ten Tails. Deducing that Jigen is planning on draining the world of chakra, Sasuke activated his Susanoo while Naruto entered Tailed Beast Mode. Jigen effortlessly overpowered the two, and despite their collaborative efforts, Jigen managed to impale Sasuke and Naruto with his black rods. Jigen resolved to seal Naruto and move to kill Sasuke, though was hindered by Naruto's shadow clones. Despite Sasuke's protests, Naruto convinced him to return to Konoha so he can live to fight another day. As Jigen was about to land a finishing blow, a heavily injured Sasuke teleported to Sakura's side, praying that Naruto would survive his entrapment before he passed out. Sasuke, still unconscious, was taken to a hospital where Sakura proceeded to heal him and managed to pull him out of critical condition. After Sasuke recovered, he learned that Kawaki used Boruto and Kawaki's Kama to go to the separate dimension and managed to save Naruto. When they returned and were treated in the hospital, Sasuke questioned his daughter about the events. Sarada explained to her parents how during their battle against Boro, it was only thanks to a strange new evolution of Boruto's Kama that they were able to defeat him. She noted that Boruto not only sprouted a horn and manifested a Byakugan in his right eye, with this massive increase in power, but was even acting differently. This concerned Sasuke, but Sakura told her daughter to rest, which the father agreed. Afterwards, Mitsuki decided to talk with Sasuke privately. He noted that Kara had taken a special interest in Boruto, calling him Momoshiki's vessel. Sasuke concluded that Momoshiki used Boruto as a means to preserve himself and potentially resurrect himself in Boruto's body. He also concluded that Kawaki is facing the same ordeal with Ishiki Otsutsuki. Shortly thereafter, Amado, the head of Kara's research and development division, arrived at Konoha and negotiated the terms of his defection. Sasuke was present during Amado's interrogation, where he learned that the scientist was responsible for providing Konoha with the coordinates to Jigen's dimension. After learning additional information about the Otsutsuki clan's history and practices, Sasuke deduced that the enigmatic clan leader is ultimately the one who gave Jigen his karma. Amado's glasses then began beeping, revealing a holographic projection of Jigen talking with Koji Kashin. They learned that Koji and Amado were working together so that Koji could kill Jigen. As they watched the fight, Amado continued divulging intel on Jigen, the Otsutsuki, and Kama. Sasuke noticed an inconsistency in Amado's explanation over the mechanics of Kama, noticing that Jigen still bore his despite having been taken over by Ishiki already. Acknowledging his point, Amado explained the unorthodox manner of Ishiki's parasitic takeover of Jigen. Sasuke listened on as Amado claimed that despite being able to transcend death with Kama, he could teach them how to kill Otsutsuki. Upon witnessing Koji's flames engulfing Jigen's body, Naruto wondered if Ishiki's end was near, though Sasuke pointed out that Ishiki still had two vessels marked with Kama, indicating that he could reincarnate twice. Sasuke voices concern that killing Jigen would make Kawaki Ishiki's sole remaining vessel, prompting Shikamaru to wonder if the entire thing was a setup from the start. Kawaki entered the interrogation room and attacked Amado, but was blocked by Sasuke's sword. Amado assured everyone that it was a misunderstanding and to turn their attention back to the battle. When Jigen's death triggered Ishiki's resurrection in his body, Amado explained this also erased Kawaki's Kama to avoid duplicates, leading Sasuke to realize that without any remaining Kama, Ishiki was vulnerable to permanent death. After Amado was officially made a citizen of Konohagakure, he explained that Ishiki's resurrection was unstable and would seek out Kawaki again to rebrand him. He also insisted that the village be evacuated and Kawaki be with Sasuke and Naruto at all times. As Boruto insisted to fight alongside his father and mentor against him, Sasuke made it clear to his student that fighting such a foe would likely result in death. Before they could settle the argument, they were alerted that Ishiki had arrived in the village. As Naruto ordered Boruto to join the evacuation, Sasuke stayed behind to talk with him. He revealed his knowledge of Boruto recently being taken over by Momoshiki's Kama. Boruto admitted he was less afraid of dying than hurting people should Momoshiki take control of him. But Sasuke swore as his teacher to stop Boruto by any means necessary. He then gave Boruto his precious old Genin forehead protector, making Boruto swear to return it in the end. Arriving to the battlefield and saving Naruto from Ishiki's attack, Sasuke began indiscriminately launching shuriken at Ishiki, who proceeded to shrink them all. When Sasuke launched his sword at Ishiki, he was deceived as it was revealed to be Boruto, who activated Kama and teleported Ishiki and himself to a separate dimension. Sasuke and Naruto soon joined to help Boruto via his space-time ninjutsu. As the Konoha nin faced down Ishiki, he grabbed Boruto, openly impressed with how far his Kama had progressed in such a short period. Sasuke suddenly swapped places with Boruto for a sneak attack, only for Ishiki to easily rebuff him. Ishiki decided the best way to get Kawaki was to present Sasuke and Naruto's corpses to the village. The fight resumed, with Naruto and Sasuke's teamwork managing to push Ishiki on the defense as it began shrinking all their attacks. However, Ishiki demonstrated a new technique, manifesting and manipulating massive black cubes that separated the duo. From there, Ishiki pinned down Sasuke and moved to kill him with his own sword, only for Boruto to jump in the way, causing him to hesitate. Boruto deduced Ishiki couldn't kill him. Boruto explained that previously, Boro noted that Boruto's wielding of a Kama would aid tremendously in Kara's plans, meaning that Boruto's life was invaluable to Ishiki. Sasuke told Boruto to run away, as their best bet was to wait out Ishiki's remaining lifespan, only for Ishiki to knock Sasuke out with a hard kick. Upon awakening, Sasuke found a battered Boruto being defended by Naruto, who released another form with Kurama to take down Ishiki. Sasuke observed as Naruto pressured Ishiki and was surprised he could keep track of his shrunken rods, something even his Sharingan had trouble doing. He took Boruto to safer distance from the battle and noticed that Naruto's chakra eventually began to weaken. Ishiki then took advantage of Naruto's chakra connection to Kawaki through the latter's prosthetic arm. From this, he teleported Kawaki to them to rebrand the boy, much to Sasuke's concern. Did you enjoy our video? Make sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.